Hey everyone, I am Vikram Salunkhe and welcome to x86 assembly. This is the next part of our C2 assembly conversion. In the last video, we saw main calls function 1, function 1 calls function 2, function 2 calls function 3. From this video, we will see function 3 returns to function 2, function 2 returns to function 1, and function 1 returns to main. So let's get started. So right now, this is how our stack is looking. This is a function 3 stack frame, this is a function 2 stack frame, this is a function 1 stack frame, this is a main stack frame, and this is an initialization function stack frame who called main. We are in Visual Studio and we are executing from function 3. The first instruction is pop EBP, that means pop top of the stack into the EBP to give back function 2 its stack frame pointer back. Step into that. And as we can see, that value got popped into the EBP. Next is a return instruction. For that, we will take address from the top of the stack and EIP will move to that address and our execution will begin from there. Click on step into. Okay, as we can see, we have moved to that address and EIP will begin execution from there. Let's see the same thing in an animation format. Function 3 is ending here. Top of the stack is 0012FF5 that will get pop into the EBP. Next instruction is we are returning. We will take the address pointed by the ESP. We will put that into the EIP and we will begin our execution from there. We are in function 2 and now function 2 is returning with the 2s. For that, we will move 2s into the EAX, step into that, and 2s got moved into the EAX. Next statement is function 2 ends here. For that, we will pop the top of the stack and we will put that into the EBP to give back function 1 its stack frame pointer back. Step into that, and as we can see, the value from the top of the stack got popped into the EBP. The next instruction is return instruction. For that, we will take the top of the stack 00401028. We will put that into the EIP and EIP will begin execution from there. Step into that. As we can see, EIP is moved to that address and we will begin our execution from there. Let's see the same thing in an animation format for a better understanding. So we have returned to the same address which we took from the stack. Now function 2 is returning with the 2s. For that, we will move 2s into the EAX, and 2s have been moved into the EAX. Next, function 2 ends here. For that, we will take top of the stack and we will put that into the EBP to give back function 1 its stack frame pointer back. Next is a return instruction. For that, we will take the value from the top of the stack, we'll put that into the EIP, and EIP will begin execution from there. Okay, this is the same address which we took from the stack, and now we are executing from function 1. Next C statement is function 1 returning with the 1s. For that, 1s will be moved into the EAX, step into that, and as we can see, those 1 moved into the EAX. Next instruction is pop top of the stack into the EBP, step into that. As we can see, top of the stack has been popped into the EBP. Next instruction is return. For that, we will take the value from the top of the stack and we will put that value into the EIP and EIP will begin execution from there. Step into that. Okay, as we can see, EIP has returned to the same address which we took from the stack. The same thing in an animation format. So we have returned to the same address which we took from the stack. function 1 is returning with the ones, and its assembly equivalent is move 1 into the EAX. So ones has been moved into the EAX. Next C statement is function 1 ends here, and for that its assembly equivalent is pop EBP. That means we will take top of the, that means we will take the value from top of the stack and we will pop that into the EBP, because we want to give back main its own stack frame pointer back. Okay, now function 1 is returning here. For that we will take the address from the top of the stack and that will get moved into the EIP, and EIP will begin execution from there. Now we are in main. Main, next C statement is main is returning with the age. For that age will be moved into the EAX. Let's tap into that, and as we can see age has been moved into the EAX. Now main is ending here. For that what it will do, first it will take the value from top of the stack and put that into the EBP to give a stack frame pointer of a function who called main. Step into that. Okay, so that got moved into the EBP. The next instruction is return. That means main will return to the function who called it, and that is located at the address 00401308. Let's step into that, and main has returned to that address. Let's see the same thing in an animation format. So we have returned to the same address which we took from the stack. Next C statement is it's returned with the age. For that we will move A into the EAX, and A got moved into the EAX. Next C statement is main is ending here. For that we will take the value printed by the ESP and move that into the EBP. Next instruction is main returning to the function who called it. For that we will take the value pointed by the ESP and that will get moved into the EIP, and EIP will begin its execution from there. So that's it for this video. We have seen lot of different variation of a one function calling another function to get an understanding of how stack works. From the next video we will see how to pass a parameter, how the local variables work with the stack, etc. So stay tuned.